2019 winter concert. My name is Gloria Calixto, and I am a junior flute player here at Hoffman Estates High School. Before we begin, I'd like to remind everyone to please turn off their phones and devices in order to fully appreciate the hard work that these students have put into the music. On behalf of the HEHS Music Department, Mr. Lowry and Ms. Drake, I would first like to thank the District 211 Board of Education and District Administration, specifically Anna Klimkowitz, the Board of Education Secretary, who is in attendance this evening. As well as Jennifer Beers, Head of Student Services, and our Principal Joshua Shoemaker for all their support, including Superintendent Daniel Cates. I would also like to thank Hoffman Estates Music Parents Association President Mrs. Christina Knapp and the Executive Board for all their hard work and dedication to the music program. Now I would like to introduce our first performing group, Hoffman's Concert Band, under the direction of Mr. Lowry and Ms. Drake.
Good evening, and thank you all for being here. The first piece of music that we are going to play is written by Frank DeKelly. It is a piece entitled Joy. And I just wanted to read a little bit of the program notes to give you an idea what the piece is about. A boisterous, uninhibited quality is implied in the music, not only at climactic moments, but also by the frequent presence of sudden and dramatic stylist contrasts. The main melody and overall mood of the work were inspired by a single event, the birth of our first child. The intense feelings that most any father would feel on such a day were, in my case, accompanied by a simple little tune which grabbed hold of me in the hours preceding her birth and refused to let go throughout the day and many days thereafter. Indeed, until I jotted it down in my sketchbook, it did not release its grip. This is Joy.
Thank you. Adapted from Ludwig van Beethoven's Symphony No. 7, this melody is one of the composer's most recognizable and performed themes. It has been so well received that it was encored at its premiere in 1813, even as the second of the three movements of the entire symphony. This premiere concert was one of Beethoven's most successful performances. The Viennese audience, weary and miserable from Napoleon's occupation in 1805 and 1809, embraced the symphony's beauty and energy. The famous Allegretto theme is also featured in the film, The King's Speech. Please enjoy.
The last piece for this part of the performance for the concert band freshman is entitled Gladiator by the great John Philip Sousa. In 1885, a long time ago, he wrote a piece for Stopper and Fisk. It was a music publishing company. They liked it so much that they asked him to write a march, and he gave them Gladiator, and then they rejected it. They said they didn't want it. Well, in classic, you know, irony, he ended up selling 10 million copies of that song, and it was his most widely celebrated march of the early 20th century. So this is Gladiator, and hope you enjoy. It's going to feature at the end a really nice flourish from our trombone section. So thank you. This is Gladiator.
All right, we now welcome our wind ensemble, sophomores and juniors. The first piece we're performing is called Old Churches by Michael Kokras. This piece explores a type of music composition called aleatoric or graphic notation. Many of the instrument parts have different symbols or directions written into their part rather than specific notes to play. Another unique element is that the instrumentation in the percussion, it calls for large suspended metal bowls, which you can see back there being played by Zoe and Gideon tonight. They're literally hitting those bowls with like hammers because that's the texture the composer is looking for there. We even explored a little bit on our own graphic notation, and we made our own compositions with different colors and shapes and lines to achieve what we wanted to portray visually, what we wanted to hear, versus writing actual notes and symbols like that in the music. Please enjoy Old Churches.
Thank you.
All right, we'll close this portion of the concert before inviting the Symphonic Winds up to join us with the second of three fantastic marches by Sousa. This one is entitled The Belle of Chicago. It was written in 1892, and as you can guess, it was dedicated to the women of the Windy City, Belle of Chicago.
Good evening, everyone. We are the Symphonic Wind Band. And tonight, well, first of all, thank you for coming. Tonight, we're going to start things off with an exceptional piece called Nobles of the Mystic Shrine, composed by Joseph Philip Sousa back in 1923. Nobles of the Mystic Shrine was meant to represent an Arabic ancient tribe called Shriro, which was founded way back in 1828. And speaking of 28, here's a little FYI. Mark your days for tomorrow, the 28th, as yours truly turns 17. Thank you. But the Shriners represented fun, fellowship, and the Masonic principle of brotherhood. I personally love this piece because I believe that this piece musically represents what the Shriners believed in and the inspiration that gave the composer the idea to make such a great piece. Now, without further ado, I'm Chris Blackshear, and here's Nobles of the Mystic Shrine. Thank you.
Australian upcountry tune was originally written for a choir of unaccompanied voices with wordless syllables in 1928 and was first premiered at the composer Percy Grainger's wedding to Ella Gielstrom. The composer based it off of a tune that he wrote 20 years prior to that entitled Upcountry Song. Here he wished to voice an Australian upcountry feeling as Stephen Foster had with American countryside feelings in his own songs. This same melody appears in several other Grainger works as well. Please enjoy Australian upcountry tune.
My name is Catherine Scalina. I'm a senior and I'm part of the percussion section. Our next song, Foundry, is composed by John Mackey and celebrates the fact that the percussionists have the ability to make just about anything into an instrument. We had to be very creative when figuring out how we were going to make up the unique sounds required for this song. During the piece, I play four large metal trash cans with mixing bowls and locks placed on top of them. Back there, and then Miss Drake plays old car parts with two hammers. With this song, we hope to transport you through our very own foundry. Please enjoy.